You have to be careful when you're feeding an aggressive beast with large teeth aquatically in a pond. What's going on YouTube? It's Jay Wilson, and today we're gonna talk about ponds. That's right, ponds. It seems today on YouTube, anything could be made a pond. So if you've got an old steamer, if you've got a random bucket, you can create a pond. Now, all you need is a place to store water, a cool hashtag, a nice thumbnail, and maybe a description of, you know, adding ultimate mega nano super large aggressive carnivorous predatory aquatic beast animal monsters into a pond. But the problem is, too many people are following in these footsteps. Too many people are making mistakes. It has nothing to do with one person, and this isn't a shot to anybody. This has to do with you. You didn't have the space, you didn't have the funds, and yet you still set up something you're calling upon to add fish that are only attracting views, clicks, likes, and shares. You're not keeping the fish sustainably, and you're not keeping the fish properly, and how are you really viewing the fish? From the top down? How? If you're not using it for breeding, what are you using it for? It's not that there's anything wrong with keeping these fish. It's not that there's anything wrong setting up a pond out of a pool, a Tupperware bin, or anything that will hold water for that matter. But what's wrong is if we're in it for the sustainability and the viability of keeping fish and allowing these fish to continue to be sold and traded within the aquarium hobby, we are doing no better than anybody else on a black market. Think about it. If we're just getting these fish, throwing them in these tubs, we're not breeding, we're not growing them out. We're simply just doing it to do it so that you can go, ooh, ah, ee. If we're doing that, then we're not doing anything that supports what we are trying to accomplish as an amazing hobby. So think about it. If you're doing it for the right reasons, then continue to do the amazing that you're doing. But if deep down inside you're really only doing it to make yourself feel better because of the views, the clicks, and the shares, then you need to check yourself before you wreck yourself. And you're so vain, I bet you think this video's about you, don't you, don't you, don't you? Folks, I wanna try to be the change, the positive change, to allow the hobby to continue to flourish. Whether you're operating under CARES, or you're following PiJack, or you're doing stuff to save a species outside of the CARES program, or you're doing something to educate the public on a species that most people cannot keep, then you are the real deal. I appreciate you taking time to watch this video. Leave your comments. How do you feel about all this? Also, there's gonna be a little structuring on this channel as I'm going to be going back to school here shortly. I wanna focus a little bit more time on the family, so the three videos will then crunch down to two, possibly one. This channel's never been about anything other than education and inspiration, so I'd like to know what day you would like to see some videos. It's not gonna be every day, it's not going to be every 2 days. I'm looking to do 2 to 1 video a week, making it very good, very educational, very inspirational, and fun. So in the comments, let me know how you feel about all of these unsustainable fish that are being populated throughout YouTube, and then let me know when you want to see a video from us. Any day. You pick it. We'll figure out if it works in the schedule. Thank you so much for watching, liking, sharing, tweeting. I appreciate everything you're doing. Remember, don't worry about everyone else in terms of how you keep your fish tank set up and the things you do throughout the hobby, but just make sure you're doing it for the right reasons and you're doing it in the most effective manner. You know what's next.